In other news this evening, jurors in the Lord Larry Hoover conspiracy trial got a chance to hear tape-recorded conversations for the first time today.
We invite you to something epic, you know? Where we hustle out of a sense of hopelessness, sort of a desperation. Through that desperation, we come addicted, sort of like the fiends we accustomed to serving. Where we feel we have nothing to lose, so we offer you, well, we offer our lives. What do you bring to the table?
Yeah, niggas talking like gangsta shit. Acting like my money ain't no good in the hood, you know what I mean? You fucking head blown off, nigga.
Talking about gangs and all that shit. We don't really talk about gangs and shit. Cause you wanna know why y'all wanna hear about that shit and we live through it.
They just like that at this point. And that's what they wanna do. They wanna create a front and they wanna slow down the actual violence, so we'll get off their back.
You got too much power, man. You like Bin Laden, man. You know what I'm saying?
Anyway, we can go to L.A. and go out to Compton and find the same stuff. It's about survival. It's about deprivation. It's about...
We smokers love me like they love Buddha. I turn your kids to a shooter. Crip niggas love me like they love Hoover. They tell me, see, careful, girl. These niggas wanna see like you. They ain't used to it. Say like you.
Why do you believe that you should be released?
On one side, brothers on the other side. It's Dodge City.
Basically, I think I've done my time. I paid my debt to society.
In 1973, one of Chicago's most infamous gang leaders was convicted of murder and sentenced to 200 years in prison. His legacy, the GDs, are still considered to be one of the most powerful gangs in Chicago's history.
Most of these killings is not false and milk for the cornflakes. Let's talk talk now. Let's talk straight talk.
I actually was influenced by a DJ that was dope. So I'm fucking with the truth, basically. That's all I got to say.
To override everything that he did wrong, and I know this, you know what I'm saying? And I know this, and I can't knock that, man, because if that's the case, how I'm going to knock everything I've been through, and now what I'm trying to do is possible.
And see, that's another thing that the media did, that they were feeding the community, they were getting these shows. They had the clothing line going on. These were very smart, you know what I mean, entrepreneurship thing that they was pulling off.
The rap. Hip-hop.
Why don't you let the people know exactly who you are, man?
Your name is what?
Larry
Hoover. I'm currently Larry Hoover's sister.
I'm Larry Hoover's mother.
Matthew, I'm off to tell the people what it's like, man, coming from the Shaolin. Niggas don't know about this shit down here with the gangs and all that.
Prosecutors say the reputed leader of the Gangster Disciples discusses street gang business with his lieutenant while Hoover is in prison.
My niggas,
you always do.
Growth and development is not necessarily what the Gangster Disciples are all about.
Tell me, in your opinion, what does GD mean to you? What is the, and we don't have to specify GD. What does...
Don't ask that. I'm not answering that one.
What does GD mean to you? Or just in your upbringing?
What that is, I really don't know.
Anybody in here know what that is?
I know that Larry Hoover's GDs are considered to be the largest, most powerful gang in Chicago.
The Black Gangster Disciples were a Fortune 500 company. They would be in the top 10%.
Well, I've been working over the past 2 years to try to redirect the energies of my immediate organization. I know what they're doing. I see the mistakes. I've made the mistakes. I'm in a position to maybe correct them before they make the same mistakes I made.